friends, this is Dr. Sangeeta and welcome back to another lecture of Dental Patchala where we help you understand and learn dentistry better and easy way. And today's topic, we are going to talk about the pre-malignant lesion and conditions that can lead to cancer if left untreated in further stages. So without further ado, let's get started. Another 10 in 10 series where we cover each topic under 10 headings in 10 minutes, and today's topic is the oral lichen planus, which is a pre-malignant condition as well as a mucocutaneous lesion. So before we get started, make sure to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon so that you don't miss any of our future notifications. So talking about oral lichen planus or lichen rubber planus, so what happens, this is a mucocutaneous lesion and the cause is the immunologic cause. We sell T cell mediated. So what happens in oral lichen planus, it is believed that there is an abnormal recognition and expression of the basal keratinocytes of the epithelium as the foreign antigen by the Langerhans cells. And since they recognize as an antigen, so they start killing it. As we have certain classes of MHA, so they start killing these cells. So there is a degeneration of the basal layer of epithelium, which takes place, we call it the lichenoid reaction. So the plaque, what happens in oral lichen planus is, first of all, it is a worldwide disease. So 0.5 to 1% of the world population is affected with the lichen planus, oral lichen planus. And there is another form, lichen planus, which has, we are talking about oral lichen planus. Also, we have something known as the lichen planus. So in case of oral lichen planus, there are papules which collapses to form the plaques. Now these oral lesions, there is formation of skin lesion as well as with the oral lesion. So these T cell mediated autoimmune disease, it leads to the oral lichen planus. There is cytotoxic CD8 cells which combine with the T cells and causes apoptosis of the oral epithelial cells. We can say the degeneration of the basal cells. Oral lichen planus is usually seen in the female population. And there are the skin lesion. We also have skin lesion in oral lichen planus, which are the small angular flat top papules which are present on the skin. So early lesion are usually red lesions, which again change to purple color or violet color. And then there the surface of these papules are covered with white grayish fine lines, we call the Wycombe striae. So what happens in case of oral lichen planus, there are a white intersecting lines, so interlacing of these white keratotic lines, these lace like structures, and the base is the red color base. So on the red color base there are these white lace like structures are there, and on these lace like structures there are tiny dots which are present on these structures. Now this is known as the Wycombe striae. And the lichen planus, see, this Wycombe striae is a typical feature of the oral lichen planus. And the lesion are, the lichen planus lesions are bilateral symmetrical. So it will involve the flexor surface of the wrist and forearm, and then followed by the inner respect of the thighs and the knees, and then the trunk is involved. So these lesions, they radiate into white or grey velvety thread-like papules, which can be arranged in angular fashion, linear fashion, reticulum fashion. So all of these pattern, they can be arranged even in the ring-like fashion. They can be placed over the buccal mucosa, tongue. So mostly it is the buccal mucosa involved. The second most common is the tongue, which is involved. Also, it can involve the gingiva, floor of the mouth, lips and palate. We also see the Grinspoon syndrome. So Grinspoon syndrome is combination of triad of three things, which is lichen planus, diabetes mellitus and vascular hypertension. So if the patient is having all of these three symptoms, we call the Grinspoon syndrome. So oral lichen planus have got many forms. The reticular form, which is the most common form of the oral lichen planus, and this there are lace like keratotic mucosal configurations are present, atrophic, as the name suggests. There is going to be mucosal erythema, atrophy of the mucosa. So there are keratotic changes as well as there is mucosal erythema, which we see. Erosive kind of lichen planus, this is the malignant, this has got the high malignant transformation. So erosive, as the name suggests, there is going to be the ulceration, there is going to be the pseudomembranous covered ulcerated and also combined with the keratotic as well as the erythematous lesions. So the bullous form of oral lichen planus is, as the name suggests, they are going to be bullous. So there are vesicular bullous lesions that are combined with the reticular or erosive lesions of lichen planus. So these can be the classification of oral lichen planus. So then coming to the histopathological feature. So if we look at the clinical view, these are usually asymptomatic lesion, but often patient can complain of burning pain on hot and spicy food. So if we take the histological cross section, then we see these rete shaped saw-shaped rete pegs. So sawtooth shaped rete pegs. We see these rete pegs, very sharp pointy rete pegs. So these short and pointy rete pegs we see. And then we also see that the most important and in fact histological feature is that there is necrosis and the liquefaction degeneration of the basal layer of the epithelium. As we have talked about that, what it causes, why it happened, because of the immunological reaction. Or this immunological reaction, T cell mediated reaction, is going to degenerate the basal layer of the cells. And this is why it is the most important histological feature of the lichen planus, that there is going to be necrosis and there is going to be liquefaction degeneration of the basal layer of the epithelial cells. And due to this liquefaction degeneration, the epithelial becomes thin and spinous, and sometimes it often comes in direct contact with the connective tissue. So in case of, we talk about the erosive kind of lichen planus, what happens? This is extremely thin and it shows complete loss of rete pegs sometimes, and in fact there is a chronic inflammatory cells which are extended up to the middle or up to the upper layer of epithelium. So what happens in the lichen planus? We see there are some round, or we see there are ovoid amorphous eosinophilic bodies which are present within the epithelium, and these bodies we call the civet bodies, or we call the hyaline bodies, or we call the fibrillar bodies. Now these bodies are present, and these bodies represent the dead keratocytes, because there is a degeneration right happening. We know that there is a degeneration, there is a necrosis degeneration of the epithelial cells. So all these degenerated or dead keratinocytes, these dead keratinocytes, when they are present in the epithelium, we call the civet bodies. These are eosinophilic bodies, right, with the dead keratinocytes in this. We call the civet bodies or the hyaline bodies or the fibrillar body, and because of this degeneration of the basal cell is present. So, and this degeneration of the basal cell, because of this, we call the lichenoid reaction to show, and the lichenoid reaction is basically to show the degeneration of basal epidermal cells. So we also see lichenoid reaction in so many diseases like secondary syphilis, we see erythema multiforme or lupus erythematosus, we also see this lichenoid reaction. Lichenoid reaction we will cover in some other video in detail, that where all other situations we see these lichenoid reactions. So talking about the histological section, so what else we see? We see the Mac-Joseph space. So there are histological clefts which are present, right? So these clefts we call the Mac-Joseph space, and the oral lichen planus, there is infiltration of lymphocytes, because we have talked about there is T cell mediated reaction. So we see that there is infiltration of lymphocytes, and which is sharply limited to the papillary as well as the superficial layer of the reticular layer of connective tissue. So we see there is a lot of lymphocytes, we see there is degeneration of the basal cell layer. Because of this immunological reaction, because of there is T cell mediated reaction, and because of this the basal layer, it gets degenerated. And all the remnant cells of the degenerated epithelium with the dead keratinocytes we call the civet bodies. And because of there is thinning, so we saw this sawtooth rete pegs. So how are we going to treat the lichen planus? So lichen planus, as we know that it is a pre-malignant condition, and we don't know that there is exact what is the cure of this. So we can manage the symptoms, we can give the patient corticosteroids. So topically we sometimes give, mostly gives the high potency corticosteroids, like we give the fluconazole, and which comes in the Lydex, and also we give the 0.05% clobetasol, which come in temovate. So also we give retinoid, temerotine. We also give the topical cyclosporine. So, but we don't do the surgical excision. Surgical excision is not indicated except where there is concomitant dysplasia that we have to identify, and only that case we do the surgical excision. Otherwise, we do not surgically excise the oral lichen planus lesions. We never do the surgical excisions. So this is about the oral lichen planus, and this very important feature is that we will see the vicum striae, which are the intersecting interlacing white lines, and on these white lines on an erythematous base, so on the red base there are white lines, lace like structures which are present in the oral mucosa. So these white lines have got tiny white elevated structures, which we call the vicum striae. This is a characteristic or typical feature of the oral lichen planus. So if you have enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up. Also, you can comment in the comment section below, and there is a link in the description box below to support me on Paytm as well as on PayPal to make free videos for you guys and to make free notes. So till then, keep reading, keep learning, stay motivated, and I'll see you soon in the next video.